out. Personality is okay. But my dear, what we need to do in this country is to establish a situation where even if it was the devil who should come and sit on top of us in Ghana, by virtue of certain procedures, certain practices, the devil cannot get away with doing whatever he wants. He would necessarily have to do what the people expect of him.
We've been through the pain of colonialism, and today we're going through colonialism, neocolonialism, in the sense that what I'm trying to say is that there was a time when we saw the white man, our colonial powers, as our enemies. But I think, no, not that I think, something that is worse than an enemy is a traitor. Yes. And when we won our freedom, some of our countries were led by some of the most noble nationalists, you know, of our time. But at the same time, with the passage of time, some of them became treacherous and rather betrayed our aspirations. In effect, what I'm trying to say is that as bad as an enemy can be, I think something worse than an enemy is a traitor. We've ended up evolving in the process of trying to modernize. We've ended up being westernized to the point where, as I sit here before you, when I wanted to even name my children African names, heroic names, I'm a Catholic. The Catholic Church, or some, that character, you know, back at home, said, no, I cannot. There'll have to be Catholic names. I mean, those Catholic names are European names. I went through an argument with this priest, and I said, listen, I have a right to my identity. Don't take away my identity, okay? I mean, Christianize me if you may, but don't westernize me. There were times, my wife and I is a great a graphic artist. We made some beautiful Christmas cards that depicted Christmas in an African setting. And the Christmas cards sold so well, even with Catholic nuns, white Catholic nuns. We wanted to secure the patent. I went to an office, the Registrar General's office, to secure the patent. Can you believe that this fellow African, you know, Registrar General, looking at my black personality, black face, told me that, no, I cannot. This was long after independence, and that it's going to take about 3 years. I said, why 3 years? He said, it'll have to go to England. It'll go to England, and it might take about 3 years before I'm granted the right to that patent or whatever it is, the register. In other words, in effect, what I'm trying to say is that, oh, so I have no right to even my creativity. I create my own, you take it away from me, and you have to send it to the colonial power. 3 years later, when they have reproduced it, and I have no more right to it. So as an African, when you're talking about democracy, etc., let's put it aside. Let me bring you to the current modern situation. We end up with injustice. We end up with corruption. We end up with poverty. We end up with the worst possible things. We end up with the image. I don't have to tell you the image that you have in Africa. I don't have to tell you. Please, I know the potential of humanity. So when you're talking about the effects of some of these things, sometimes, you know, these superpowers must learn to accommodate and to live and to accept patriotic leadership, patriotic citizens. Too often, they're happier with people who are not patriots. But if the media, especially in America, for instance, could give you both sides of the story as pertains to foreign policies and foreign actions, you will bring so much pressure to bear, because you still live in a world with the capacity and the ability to be able to influence your president. You can impeach your presidents like in America. So you as a people still have power, unlike us. In Africa, they disempower. Let me just say something. I have a little theory that the world is manipulated. I may be wrong, but the world is manipulated by the multinational corporations, the media, some parts of the media, and the intelligence apparatus. They work as a triumvirate, and they are neatly sandwiched, like the ham, like your tomato, whatever it is. They are neatly sandwiched in between the governed people, you, the governed ordinary people, and the governors. That is where the manipulation takes place. And there is a symbiotic relationship between the triumvirate and sometimes at this level. And if we do not make every possible attempt to return morality, when we're talking about the immorality of international politics, the immorality in business ethics is also percolating downwards, and the criminal corrupt thing that goes on in my world is bad. So the sooner we begin to return, to restore some sense of morality in business ethics, in politics, in the media, intelligence apparatus, with beliefs, conviction that this is wrong, etc. After all, if you're talking about globalization, then please, let the same value, what is good for the goose, let it be good for the gander.
Honorable Dr. Idris Musa Andele, it is simply humiliating.
Happy to see you once again. Yabe Yenu, very short, so that you can...
And it's the right size, too. I don't think I could have worn this thing. See, I take it off. Let me try it and see. Come on.
One thing we want to have the right whistle to have this done.
In spite of all these, but she's getting too fair. In spite of all these issues, let us as a party not overlook the challenges plaguing our party. If we forget to clean our house well and spend our energies only attacking our rivals, it will not portend anything positive
for our future.
So, my dear beloved Dr. Nana Ackerman Rawlings, my colleagues, ministers of state, honorable lecturers of the various faculties, your excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I think I prefer the ladies. Brothers and sisters, in Africa, it gradually
to that. Yeah. Now, what happened? Many years later, when I go here, Madame Fatia Nkrumah, my wife, then I go for you. Okra, no coffee, no, Madame Fatia, no coffee. Or this channel, a potodium, no motium. No alpha, handkerchief, towel. No, yes, sir. Oh, super. I'm a Madame Fatia. Nay, yes, you didn't cheat. Well, there is, oh, who 40 cents, or oh, any papa, oh, 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 yes, we are fire hanging, yes, we, yes, who be? Oh, you know, Kufo, the whole name of far speed. Now, this tree hole next to Dr. Kwame Nkrumah grave, the coffee. No, that's, or this tree grave, no, this, Madame Fadia, we shall. From that moment, that national monument that we built to honor that man became a family graveyard. You see how his grave was desecrated? Mills Moon, John Moon, you know, see Buya Kumais. You have chopped into the man's name. Now, what you said, where did why? When Kumai, look at what his enemy pretended, so and so and so and so. Now, desecrate his national monument. You get it? Sani Kanyama, Muntiasia. Yeah, we were mamunim, Philip. And yet, sir. Minawati, and yet, sir. Compound is big. You could have dug 101 holes and put Madame Fatia also there. Build a 3-times story building monument. You did not have to do that. Under the same monument under which Dr. Kwame Nkrumah was. It fooled all of you.
Ladies and gentlemen. Tonight it has been so good, so electrifying, that I just have to, on behalf of all Ghanaians, and especially those of you who are here, say a big thank you for making this a night to remember. Ladies and gentlemen, when I saw her in my office a few weeks ago, I don't know what I said to her, how beautiful she was still looking. But after she left, I was commenting to someone that she's looking as beautiful as my wife. and they've left us to age and gray. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know what the world would have been like without blues. You know, and even especially so for my continent, Africa, and Ghana. I mean, can you imagine how miserable and depressed people would be without good music from such artists, from musicians like her, like the others who perform, the younger ones and the older ones? The kind of music that can penetrate your heart. I'm not surprised somebody coined that phrase, music is food for the soul, as Jerry Biambole said earlier. Ladies and gentlemen, good music to penetrate your heart to the point of drawing tears out of you. Good, vibrant music that would make you dance and gyrate that you would think hell was on fire. Ladies and gentlemen, I cannot come to a show like this without coming up here to say a big thank you.
Oh! good morning and welcome to the Holy Spirit Cathedral, where we're here for the Thanksgiving Memorial Mass for flagless Reverend Jerry John Rawlings retired. He died a year ago today, and today on Friday, 12 November, we're remembering him here at the Holy Spirit Cathedral. There are quite a number of dignitaries who already are in there. And pretty shortly, I'll be taking you in so that we get a sneak peek just before the program begins. And fortunately, I have someone who knows the former president, or the late former president, really, really well. And he's going to be walking us through what we're at to expect happening today, this morning, at the Holy Spirit Cathedral. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
And I want him, for purposes of this, to take off his mask so that we get to see his face. All right, so someone I'm sure you haven't seen in a really, really long time, that's Noema Donko, a former minister with the Rawlings administration at the time. So good morning and welcome to Joy News.
Good morning.
So we're live on Joy News, and we're live on Joy Prime as well. So there's Prime Morning, and then there's the AM show on Joy News.
Good morning.
So we would want you to walk us through,
very well,
before the program itself starts,
yeah,
walk us through what we are to expect.
Good.
I'll be coming to that.
Right.
Before then, though, where have you been?
Well, Israel, I'm around. I now spend most of my time trying to mentor the United Nations Youth Association of Ghana and Africa.
Okay.
I just returned from Kenya to address the African group of the United Nations Youth Association.
All right.
So we have to give what we have for our youth before we leave.
Yeah. And you're looking good, I must say.
By the grace of God.
We thank God. Okay, so we know this morning is the memorial.
Thanksgiving service
for the late president.
Right.
And we'll be speaking to a few people who are going to be telling us what they make of him and how they remember him and all of that. But because we are the first person we're going to be speaking with, I'd want you to tell us how you remember him and what it has been like for this past year that he's been on.
I want to say that Rawlings, appearance on the political scene was by divine arrangement. As you know, he spent close to 2 decades in office, 79 through to 81 and all the way to 2001. So you can say that the man came because for him, everything that he did was for the people. Because if you don't think about the people, then whatever you do will be something different. So those of us who followed him, the one thing that we remember him for was the fact that he believed in social justice, that let us all live as brothers and sisters so that there will be life would be very dignified for our people, and also ensure that we are all very, very happy with ourselves. Sometimes, if we look at his management style, it is something that was very intriguing. Here you are having a military officer, and as you know, the military has been trained with that kind of hierarchical order of command and control. But then he also believed that let us have a system where we can agree to give those who are operatives the free will to operate. He will give you the chance to operate on your own will, but if you screw up, sorry for using the word screw up, it will not make you a scapegoat. You will learn something out of what you would have done. And then if there are any lessons to be learned, then we can all, as a people, move on.
Okay.
But then make sure that you are doing it with integrity, without any motives of having
Okay. Hopefully we're going to have more time to talk about his legacy and how you remember him. But I just want to point out to people that, because I'm the COVID ambassador, I'm always on the lookout for the COVID protocols. So we can see here the wash stations so that people, before they get in, they can wash their hands and before they get to go in. At this point, Mr. Neoma, it's okay for you to put on your mask, because we're going to be going in there.
Thank you very much.
And we're going to be having a conversation. He's going to walk us through some of the dignitaries who have come already, because it's COVID, everybody else is in a mask. But fortunately, you see,
people, and even with a mask on, he can tell who's in. So we're going to walk into the auditorium in a bit. The program hasn't started,
right?
So it's fine for us to quickly sneak in,
right,
and get to have a conversation, and then before the program starts, so we don't disrupt the program. Okay, I've already been in here. We're live on TV.
Observed. But as you can see, we have very important dignitaries all across the party. Officials, you can see the party chairman is here, Kofiato, Evisa Free Ankara, the party executives are all here. Then you can see those who also operated with President Rawlings during his time. Alhaji Muhammad Idrisu is around, who was the presidential advisor and of course now the chairman of the Council of Elders. Alhaji Muhammad Idrisu is here. You have all the party, the PMDC people around here. Of course, the First Lady is also around, the former First Lady is also around. And then from government, the President, of course, is not in town. So the Vice President, the Chief of Staff, the Ministers, Minister of Interior, Minister of Lands and Forestry, all of them are all here.
Maybe what we're going to do is to go to the front.
Okay.
And then as we walk through, you point out some of the people.
Okay. So now you can see the party chairman.
We're just seeing the party chairman. The party chairman, for example, Fofo. And then the former president, good morning. So the former president is also coming.
So after the home meeting. So please, when you go out during the mass, and they ask you to stay
on outside. On at the
please
moment.
Bear with us.
But yeah, we'll try and see if we can do this.
Our former president was very disciplined,
we know the people who are going to be here.
Right.
These
are the family members. The family members
are going to be here.
The family members
are going to be here.
Okay.
And then First Lady and his team on the other side, and then the party on the other side, the extreme end.
Okay, so let's go through. So you're saying this first pew,
it's for the family members and the traditional authorities.
And the traditional authorities.
Yes.
They're going to have the first pew.
Yes.
And then the middle pew, or the second pew.
Yeah.
Counting from this side.
Yeah. So this pew is reserved for the public. It's reserved for the public.
Members of the public.
The public, yes.
All right.
Yeah. And then we have the family.
The third pew.
Yeah, it's for the family.
Okay.
So you can see our former First Lady. Our former First Lady seated the children of the former president. Our First Lady is here. The children are here. Of course, they are on the first queue. The second queue was part of the family members who are also part here this morning for the program. Yeah, so this seat is reserved for the family of the former first president.
All right.
Yes.
So then, and good morning to you. We're at Joy News. So we commiserate with you. Even as you remember the first day.
Right.
So then you do.
You have the party.
The very first part.
Yeah.
The press. You
have the former president.
With the former
president here. Alhaji Muhammad Idrisu. Alhaji Muhammad Idrisu is here. You have the former president. You have the party chairman. You have the members of the party executives.
Please,
the party executives who are also here this morning. This is the seat for the party.
Nobody should cross
right.
The front
anymore. So we're going to go through to the back
right.
And get to see the other people who are there.
Okay.
And the members of the press.
One is that?
So yes, we're going to get to see the other dignitaries who are here. As we indicated, the first few, as we can see now.
Right. And then our deputy is also here. So this is purely for the, this seat is reserved for the party executive.
Okay.
Yeah. Shall we rise and welcome the vice president?
Right, so we're learning the vice president is coming in at this point. We would have to step out and get to meet them as they make their way. So we can catch a glimpse of them here as they're making their way into the Holy Spirit Cathedral, and then we're going to meet them out there at the front.
Okay.
It appears we actually have the Vice President on the side already coming in. So the Vice President is coming, has come in already, and he's exchanging pleasantries with the party official, the former, the ex-president. And then also greeting some of the family members who are gathered here, after which he will also take his seat. Right, so he's taking his seat at this point.
Gentlemen.
All right, so
please
let's retreat and then continue with our conversation. Right. So we've seen the vice president. We're also expecting. Who else are we expecting? Are we expecting the president to
the
be?
The president is not in the country, so the vice president, in short, is representing the president. And of course, the chief of staff and the ministers are all here. The Minister for Interior here, and also apart from the ministers, we also have the military establishment. The Chief of Army Staff, General Pompekra, is already here,
right.
And so with the naval officers who are also here. All the military establishment hierarchy are here in attendance.
And we're expecting the program to start at 9 o'clock.
Exactly, at 9 o'clock. And then after 9, when we are done with this program from here, we'll go to the military cemetery where we shall go and unveil the tomb of the former president at the military cemetery.
The military cemetery, which is by the stadium, or the one?
No, the one at the Achado. Yes. So from here, we move to the military cemetery to unveil the tomb.
Right.
And after that, we'll go to the party office where the party is organizing a program in commemoration of the passing on of the former president.
So we understand that this memorial service is actually being organized by the family. It's the family that's in charge of it.
Yes, it's the family that is in charge.
Beyond the events that the party is going to be having, is there any other program that we're expecting?
Yeah, the party has issued instruction to all the regions. But the regions must also observe this program that we are having here in the regions. So it's going to be a national program. So we expect the regions also to do the same thing over in the regions as well.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So we are pretty much set, and the program, as we're indicating, should be starting in a few minutes.
Right.
We don't expect it to go start anytime after 9.
Right.
So looks like we're going to be sticking to time, especially when we have the vice president already seated
right,
representing the president here.
Right.
We have ex-president John Mahama, who's also seated here together
right,
with the party chairman, the NDC party chairman.
Yeah.
They also seated, as well as some other executives of the NDC, plus some former ministers as well are also present here.
Right.
So we can retreat at this point and have a little conversation
okay,
before actually the program actually gets to start. Right, so this is something we also want to capture. We're having the ministers. So at this point, I believe we can end our conversation,
right,
so that we can go over to the main event so that we can follow what's going on.
Very
thank
well.
You very much.
Most welcome. Uncle, most
for
welcome.
Making time to speak with us
most
this
welcome.
Morning.
It's a pleasure.
And we'll
pleasure.
Come to you again.
Very well. Very well.
All right.
Have a nice day.
Thank you. So we're crossing over to the main to get to listening in and listening in to the service itself, which is just about starting. But to those of you who are watching us, this is on the AM show on Joy News as well as Joy Prime Morning on Joy Prime. My name is Israel Aye. Let's enjoy the service.
that all of us sit. God creates us for a purpose. He creates us into this world to live, to praise Him, to worship Him, and also to listen to His voice and do His work here on this earth. On 22nd June 1947, the Lord fashioned our Father, our brother, Flight Lieutenant Colonel John Collins, into the world. He became the father of the nation. He worked with his heart. He said his family, and he said his mother and motherland, Ghana. In the year 2020, 12 November, a year today, the Lord called him back to himself. We've gathered here to thank the Lord for the Father that He gave us, Father for all, Father for all. We are here to continue to pray for His soul. We are also here to pray for ourselves, that prayer is one day. We also find ourselves there in the presence of God. On behalf
and zeal. he left the country that he fought years and succeeded in giving back the Ghanaians their national pride. The late Rawlings saw his leadership. He saw his leadership role to be that of watchdog for ordinary people. And he addressed problem of incompetence, injustice, and corruption as much as he could. This is the man, my dear people of God, you are remembering and celebrating today. It is my prayer that God will continue to bless him and get his people rest. I must like this, require that all bishops be present, but they cannot be here due to the conference in the one. They have asked me to convene with their visitors. Let us also take this opportunity to welcome all who have joined us in this celebration. We have made our sins and prepared ourselves to serve in the ministry of Christ's love. I confess Almighty God on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Let's pray. O God, glory of the faithful and life of the just, by the death and resurrection of your Son, we have been redeemed. Look mercifully on your servants, on your departed servant, Jerry John Rawlings, that just as he professed the mystery of your resurrection, so he may merit to receive the joys of eternal happiness. So our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Shall we please take our seats as we listen to the readings? The one assigned to take the first reading should come up to the sanctuary and read.
You know, these superpowers must learn to accommodate and to live and to accept patriotic leadership, patriotic citizens.
For everything, there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to pluck what is planted. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to break down, and a time to build up. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones, and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to seek, and a time to lose. A time to keep, and a time to cast away. A time to rend, and a time to sow. A time to keep silent, and a time to speak. A time to love, and a time to hate. A time for war, and a time for peace. What gain has the worker from his toil? I have seen the business that God has given to the sons of men to be busy with. He has made everything beautiful in its time. Also, he has put eternity in man's mind, yet so that he cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end. The word of the Lord. We shall turn to page 2 of the brochure and join the choir in singing the responsorial psalm.
Hello, my name is Evans Mensah, and you can relive all the fun and excitement on Top Story, Newsnight, and of course, Ghana Connect via podcast. All you need to do is to log on to myjoyonline.com/podcast. Search for your favorite show and relive the moment. Joy 99.7 FM, your radio for discerning listening. Joy 99.7.
Is near to you, my goal.
To acclaim the gospel.
be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And when I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may also be. And you know the way where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Sisters, on a day like this, we expect to hear your bishop speak some words to you. But here I am, I cannot, due to my invalidity. I've asked Father Tony Asari to do that on my stay. So, Tony, you're welcome.
Hello, my name is Nathaniel Atto. You can catch up with all the fun and inspiration on the Joy Sports Link here on Joy 99.7 FM, together with all other shows over and over again. It's very simple. All you need to do is go to myjoyonline.com/podcast and relive all of those fun moments over and over again. Joy 99.7 FM, your radio for discerning listeners.
Joy 99.7.
Your Grace, Metropolitan Archbishop of Accra, Most Reverend John Bonaventure Kofi, Monsignor, Senior Brother Priest, members of the clergy here present, Your Excellency, Dr. Bawumia, Vice President of the Republic, and delegation of the present government, members of Parliament here present, our immediate past President, John Mahama, and your entourage, our past First Lady, Nanakunedu Adma Rawlings, children and family members, friends, sympathizers of our dear father, the High Command of the Security Services here, invited guests, brothers and sisters in Christ, members of the press, all protocol observed, permit me to address you from now, brothers and sisters in Christ, because this is what I'm familiar with. I am humbled this morning to be called upon to share a few thoughts with you after we have all heard the two readings from Ecclesiastes and from the Gospel of John. I pray that these few thoughts will find a place in your heart and in my heart, and especially for the Biri family, may you find consolation and comfort. Beloved in Christ, the first reading from Ecclesiastes reminds us of this, that there is a time and a time and a time. Time is a key element of life. In fact, it grounds us. Everything in the words of Qohelet, the one attributed with the message of Ecclesiastes, indicates to us that every occupation under heaven has a time. Everything takes place in chronological order. Time sets the limit of every human endeavor. All shall pass, the earth and everything in it. All is transient, temporary, momentary. No doubt, all too soon, we are celebrating 1 year of the passing of Chairman John Jerry Rawlings. We must watch where we invest our hearts and energies in life. The Gospel of John consoles us. The farther we travel down this road of life, the greater is the realization that this is not our home. Heaven is. The disciples of Jesus had good reason to be troubled, because as they reclined at table a few moments earlier, he spoke of the traitor in their midst. John 13, verse 21. And he's leaving them and going where they could not follow. Jesus saw in their faces that night of confusion, hurt, disappointment, fear, frustration, and bewilderment. Their world was caving in around them like an earthquake. But he says this to them: do not let your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. These are the words of the Good Shepherd comforting the hearts of his troubled sheep. You believe in God, believe also in me, is the revelation of Jesus' own heart to them. The disciples were perplexed and fearful, and Jesus had earlier told them, where I am going, you cannot come. And Peter will ask, where are you going? Thomas will also add, we don't know where you are going. How can we know the way? And Philip The third disciple will say, "Show us the Father. That is sufficient." Thomas was perplexed about the way. How can we know the way if we do not know where you are going? The disciples that night could not comprehend continuing without Jesus. Jesus did not promise them their troubles were going away. He told them he would be with them in the midst of their troubles. He would be their stabilizing force and strength. Thinking beautiful thoughts will not make our pain go away. But let us stop a moment and ask, what is it that is troubling you today? What is flooding your troubled heart today? The hurt of those disciples that night was no different from the hurts we are experiencing today. Jesus was telling his disciples to give him those troubles that were boiling over and flooding their hearts. His death was no make-believe, it was real. They felt the trauma of it before them. Jesus recognized what they were experiencing and gave them comfort. And so, their family and friends gathered, dear family and friends gathered, and our chiefs. It seems I left you out. Our chiefs, distinguished chiefs, let us be consoled, let us be comforted, and let us be assured of the Lord's presence in our pain. In the words of Thomas A Kempis, in his book, The Imitation of Christ, I quote these few lines to you. Follow thou me, I am the way and the truth and the life. Without the way, there is no going. Without the truth, there is no knowing. Without the life, there is no living. I am the way which thou must follow, the truth which thou must believe, the life for which thou must hope. If thou remain in my way, thou shalt know the truth, and the truth shall make thee free, and thou shalt lay hold on eternal life. Unquote. Beloved in Christ, Jesus is the only way to the Father in heaven. He has come to take us to the Father. Everything is ready. All we have to do is follow him. He has prepared the way. Jesus is not asking us to follow him by name as Christians or by confession, daily shouting his name, but by living his principle of life. And so the Jesus people are not just Christians, but anybody called by name, anybody influenced by the word of God, which is alive each day. It goes beyond religion and religious persuasions. It is in the hearts of men and women. Beloved in Christ, may the Lord cleanse our father, Jerry John Rawlings, of his sins, knowingly and unknowingly. And when he has found his peace with the Lord, may Chairman remember his wife and children, friends and family he has left behind, because he is in a better place. For the rest of us who are living, may the words of Jesus this day resound and resonate in our hearts and direct our thoughts and actions in our daily life. Namely, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. Let us think about this. Amen.
What's up, guys? My name is Sammy Forson, host of the Weekend City Show and Ignition right here on Joy 99.7 FM. Well, anytime you happen to be busy and you miss out on your favorite shows right here on Joy FM, here's what you can do. Log on to myjoyonline.com/podcast. Just go on there and you'll find all your shows on demand 24/7. There you can catch up. Remember, Joy FM remains your radio for discerning listeners. Radio. Joy 99.7.
We come to Father, God our needs. Let us pray for Flight Lieutenant Gregor Rollins. In baptism, he died with Christ. May he share in fullness of his resurrection. We pray to the Lord. We pray for those here today, that our memory of Lieutenant Gregor Rollins, whom we loved, inspire us with a renewed love for all our brothers and sisters. We pray to the Lord. May the family of our late former president, Flight Lieutenant Gregor Rollins, be embraced by consolation and peace. We pray to the Lord. We pray for our leaders of our country and for ourselves, that the Lord may open our ears to listen to his word, be alert to the prompting of the Spirit, that we may be faithful in living according to the gospel. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all ourselves here today and for all members of our church, that we may be prepared for our own death when God will call us by name to pass from this world to the next. We pray to the Lord. Yes, we all have something to tell the Lord. So in silence of our hearts, let us put our private petition before him.
With the prayers of those who cry to you, benefit the souls of you, of your servants, O Lord. Free them, we pray, from all their sins, and make them sharers in your redemption. We pray through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Please be seated.
Now time to give our offering. The harmonious choral choir will lead us in medley of songs. The choir, the ushers will direct us. Please come along with your valuables. Don't leave your handbags and phones in your pews, especially those at the back. Come along with your valuables. Thank you very much. Please give generously.
Yeah.